Today we are focusing on the celebration of harvest. Every person in the world is special and loved by God, and every person in our big global family has the right to enough food for a healthy life.
People might be hungry because they aren't able to grow food or they don't have enough money to buy food. Sometimes farmers cannot afford the seed they need to grow. Sometimes storms, floods destroy their harvest.
Hunger is a big problem and it's not easy to solve. Sometimes we ignore problems hoping they'll go away.
God asks us not to ignore each other, but to help one another. Together we can solve problems.
Response. Let's celebrate the harvest of water, field, and tree, and sing how God has given all the love to you and me.
God, be kind to us and bless us. May the light of God's face shine on each one of us.
Response. Let's celebrate the harvest of water, field, and tree, and sing how God has given all the love to you and me.
Let God's way and his praise be seen on earth. Let everyone say thank you to God.
Response. Let's celebrate the harvest of water, field, and tree,
and sing how God has given all the love to you and me.
Let all the nations of the world celebrate. Let everybody say thank you to God.
Response. Let's celebrate the harvest of water, field, and tree, and sing how God has given all the love to you and me.
Jesus calls us to help those people in need. Let us remember this as we pray together.
We pray for the world leaders, that they may make wise decisions for the good of all people, so that everyone may have enough to eat. Lord, in your mercy.
Pray for our parish family and friends that we may be moved to share what we have with our brothers and sisters around the world. Lord, have mercy.
We pray for the work of CAFOD that it may continue to help people to get their fair share of food that God gives us for all. Lord, in your mercy.
nearby, and the birds ate it, came and ate it up.
As the farmer continued to plant the seeds, some of them fell on soils that was full of rocks. There was not much dirt around the rocks, so the seeds started to sprout and grow the very next day. The only problem was there was little dirt, so the plants didn't put down roots, which would help them become strong and healthy. In the afternoon, the sun was very hot, so the plants had started to grow in the rocky soil with it and died because they had no root in the ground.
Some of the other seeds fell on the soil that had been taken out with the weeds and thorns. The weeds and thorns grew faster and taller than the plants from the seeds. So they choked out the plants that the sower wanted to grow.
Finally, some seeds fell on the good soil that had been ploughed and weeded to make a good place for the seed to grow. Those seeds made healthy plants and produced good fruit.
Jesus wanted this parable to teach the disciples a lesson, and it is also the lesson that he wants us to learn today. The seed that the sower was planting in the story represents the teachings of God's word. Our heart represents the soil where the sower planted the seeds. Jesus wants us to listen to his words and grow in love for him.
Generous God, thank you for creating this world with enough food for all to share.
Help us to play our part in making sure that all people can have their fair share of food to eat. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.